Everybody, my name is Mindy Sterling, and oh, thank you so much for loving this film and embracing it and enjoying it and having questions about it. So I want to just tell you how much it meant to me and how wonderful it was to work on it and all of that. I was approached to do it, and first of all, I love anything that has to do with women. I love women directors, women writers, you know, anything that that is the women's point of view, and because I really think that nobody can capture that more than women, to really know what's going on in our minds. And these are women that, you know, really wanted to help a friend. I think the bonding of women is just so natural and so supportive. And so I know I, Mindy, would do anything for any one of my friends. And half the time I call them and feel like they're family. So they, you know, kind of threw it out there. What can we do? How can we get money? And came up with this crazy idea of robbing a bank. Which, not that I have ever thought of that, like in my real life, you know, in my youth, I've taken things that aren't mine. I think that the women in the film, it wasn't a joke, it wasn't jokey, it wasn't really trying to make fun of them or their idea or the idea of it having this dream or fantasy that they, you know, did it in a different time period. I thought was really clever and really interesting. And how fun was it to just look like that and get into that and becoming our own Bonnie and Clyde reference. So I think that, you know, again, women will go to great lengths to help somebody out. And they weren't gonna kill anybody. No. Yeah, we are in a very strange time, as you know, and this is just kind of scary in so many different ways. You know, I don't wanna get sick, I don't wanna die, I don't want any of my friends or family to do that. I don't want anybody there. And you know, this quarantine and staying at home is really tough, but we all do the best we can in whatever capacity that we have. Some people have a lot of people that they live with, and that's a nightmare. Some people don't have anybody that they live with, and that's a nightmare. So yeah, I think it's just tough because we're not used to being told really what to do, like all the time. And but I would so rather deal with this and have the highs and lows that I have than to be put on a ventilator, or to have given somebody else that and put on a ventilator and maybe near death and you can't say goodbye, you can't see any of your family. And that just frightens me and scares me and makes me so sad. So sometimes I want to keep up on what's going on the other hand, I get really involved in it and a little a little paralyzed. So I'm glad that I am where I am, and I'm glad that I have food, and I'm glad that I'm healthy. But I don't know, this is some kind of a sign for all of us to wake up and take care of each other, I guess. So I think that's what my character and the other girls did in the movie. We took care of our friend, our lady, and we would do whatever as long as we don't hurt anybody or put anyone in danger. Though those guns are scary as shit. It was kind of cool. Thank you.